It's great to have you. We'll just start off with introducing yourselves and your designation as NANTAP officials. Okay, so let's begin with you, sir.
My name is Steve Ogundele, and I'm the National Deputy President of NANTAP.
Of NANTAP, wow, great to have you, sir. And you, sir?
Yeah, my name is Shaibu Husseini. I'm here in my capacity as a member of the World Theatre Day Organizing Committee for 2016 and for Lagos NANTAP.
For Lagos NANTAP.
Yeah.
Okay. At different times now, World Theatre Day is an annual celebration of theatre and all that. Now let me ask you now, what exactly is World Theatre Day? What exactly is it?
Well, World Theatre Day, it's a day specially set aside for practitioners to remember their art. It's a day that was set aside by International Theatre Institute in 1961 to commemorate the performing arts, the theatre arts practice all over the world. And since that year, it's been a yearly celebration for all practitioners all over the world and all international theatre centres to sort of do some kind of advocacy and remember their arts, the profession, their career, and project it through so many means, so many media of seminal workshops, sketches, stage performances, theater talks, and so on. And we have been doing that. NANTAP started about 25 years ago.
Yes.
And from inception, we have been doing, remembering this day, March 27th, as it concerns us as practitioners. And that's why we're doing this year again. Though it was done yesterday, but of course, the celebration still continues, you know, from 27th throughout the year.
All right, sir. Is there some form of collaboration between NANTAP and the Lagos Theatre Festival? Because I noticed that there's a similarity with both celebrations. The Lagos Theatre Festival, there's a workshop, there are stage plays everywhere. Is there a collaboration?
Yeah, a lot of our members are part of the Lagos, especially the one organized by the British Council, the Lagos Theatre Festival.
Mm-hmm.
But that's a festival, and you can hold festivals anytime. You can, you know, organize festivals on your own or as a group or whatever. But this one is a special day that we use to draw attention to theater practice worldwide. Mm-hmm. On this day, everything stops, and we say, look, what has been the contribution of theater to society? What has been the contribution of theater to nation building? Where is theater today? What is happening to the practitioners and all that? And then the ITI, which is the institute that we all belong to, International Theatre Institute, got to UNESCO, and UNESCO adopted that day.
Yeah.
So this is the 54th year in the celebration of the International Theatre Day. And like I said, everything we do on this day is just to call attention to theatre practice. And we think that it has helped us a great deal to just stop on a special March 27 to ask ourselves, to appraise the state of the industry. And I'm sure if we want to do like a genuine appraiser, you will know that theater is not where it should be and all that. And so this is the day that we want to say, okay, look, these are things that we need to do, and these are things that we should do. This is the role that government has to play. This is the role that the private sector has to play. This is the role that we as individuals have to play. And so we decided that every year we must join the rest of the world to mark this day. Stage a performance, have an advocacy talk, hold workshops, and generally just appraise the state of theater practice in Nigeria.
Well, the phone numbers are open. You can call in and talk to us concerning World Theater Day. Numbers to call in 0809-1-222-83-8485-86. All right, now, something I want to ask now. When we look at, let's take the United States as an example. You have the cinema culture, and of course you have Broadway.
Yes.
Both of them are they are doing very well individually on their own. Now, recently we've seen an upsurge. We had the cinema culture much earlier in the days, you know, back then. I remember going to see Indian movies, you know, in small you know, cinemas and all of that. But then the cinema culture is, you know, it's, there's a resurgence in that culture. But then, as much as I know that at different points we have plays, we have little theaters that we can go watch plays, word has not been spread so much. People don't really, really appreciate the fact that you can go out and see a play. What is NANTAP doing concerning that to, you know, to make people go out there? Because I think people appreciate plays. Mm. I wouldn't say they don't appreciate it, but then people don't actually go out to see them. What is NANTAP doing in that regard?
Well, I think you have also touched on the core of the problem, the resurgence in the film production or the video production industry. But if you ask me sincerely, I think part of our problem is, one, economy, and then two, general insecurity. You want to ask yourself, why do I need to go and watch a play on stage when I can sit in the comfort of my bedroom or living room and watch a movie, which is all over the place now? Mm-hmm. So the culture of going to watch play is gradually reducing, just like my colleague said earlier on, that not much has been done in the area of theater. But you see, we cannot equate the two. They have two different functions. Maybe one is mass media, that's the film or the television. But the live theater, like we said, is a mirror of the society. It's a live thing. We see ourselves, we put ourselves on stage. They perform two different functions. But like I said, because of the economy, the kind of economy that we run, and the state of poverty of our people, and the general insecurity of, because plays, you probably will want to, when you have worked during the day, you want to go and watch a play when you are done with your day's work, and that would take you, that would take place maybe later in the day. Are you sure you are going to come back home in one piece? Mm-hmm. Where you are watching the play, are you sure there is enough security for me and my property where I go to watch the play? So you cannot remove the fact that there is a dearth in the theater-going culture from the general social, political, and economic situation of the country. Mm-hmm. And that's why we're saying that if government can look more in the area of creating or establishing cottage theaters, if I have to travel just 1 kilometer to watch a play from my house, I live in Ikorodu, even within Ikorodu as a local government, I can go and see a play. I feel more secure. I can tell myself that, look, I'm a Christian. I say, okay, Christ, I'm going out tonight. I'm going to see a play. But because it's within Ikorodu, not like traveling from Ikorodu to National Theatre or to VI in
Muson
Center, mm-hmm. or the other one, Terra Culture, mm-hmm. to go and watch a play. I want to, I'm a father of beautiful girls. Mm-hmm. I want to consider that. So we're saying, let government and the private sector assist in creating cottage theater, at least one in every local government. We've seen it before. A government in this country established two political secretariats for each local government. I remember very well, NRC and SDP. Mm-hmm. There were a secretariat for each of them in every local government in Nigeria. So why can't there be just one cottage theater for each local government so that people can travel very short distances to go and watch a play? Look at what British Council is doing. They're now taking, it's a guerrilla theater thing. Mm-hmm. They're now taking theater to communities. Mm-hmm. That's because they have also realized that having an organized theater section like you have in Terra Culture in National Theater does not attract much patronage. So they've decided to take theater to the people. That's what we want government to do. And we'll be advocating this for long. Let the private sector and government come to our aid. And we are practitioners. We're ready to go on stage. Look at what Adeo just did. I developed goose pimples where I was. Mm. That is what theater can do to you. It touches you. It hits you where you cannot resist. And so when that is done, I'm sure that the theater going culture of those days that you refer to, will say come back.
I was going to add to that to say that in addition to the issue of space, in addition to the issue of insecurity, to do theater the way it's supposed to be done, you need to support theater, provide
the enabling environment and also provide some form of grant. For instance, the theme of this year's celebration is theater as a unifying force, you know, for national cohesion, and then theater against corruption and terrorism. If you have to take a play, for instance, to a local community to preach, to tell people, to conscientize people about the need for us to live together, it costs a lot of money. Mm-hmm. It is not like film, where you just get people, pay them their fees, they come and you shoot under a week. But for to do this little skit that we just watched before we came now, this guy has to rehearse for weeks.
Right, sir. Mm-hmm.
And it involves a lot of people. It involves you building a set. It involves you moving things from one place to the other. Mm-hmm. So really, you cannot remove theater from the sociopolitical environment. If the economy is down, theater definitely will get down. Okay. If there are security challenges, theater will be affected. If there are no infrastructure, theater too will suffer it, because theater needs space. We have artists. Every year we turn out theater artists, but there is no space for them to perform. Even if you have the space, the problem will be how to organize them. It costs a lot of money to organize theater. Theater is not what you do and you expect like profit. And I'm not saying that you cannot make money from doing theater, but you don't expect profit immediately. But what you find here is that everybody wants to invest in theater, wants money like tomorrow, like today. And theater is not like that. So we are saying that these things have to, we need to create the enabling environment. And there's so much that theater can do. I mean, watching this small skit at home, there's so much that has gone into the mind of somebody who is watching at home, because he's seeing it live. There is nothing, this doesn't look for me like packaged or something. I mean, you know, it's talking to you live. And when he did that, I remember playing this same, playing in a scene where this thing happened, and Olu Jacob was the lead character, you know, and it was even me as an actor on stage, I was almost like I had good pimples, you know, watching him. It's a good skit, you know, and it's a good way to start this segment, really.
Okay, now, sir, you talked about the problem facing theater in Nigeria, the space and everything, but there was an experiment some time ago, because stage is a very, very great influence to the Nollywood industry. Now, someone did an experiment and he made sure that there was a stage performance and there were cameras to capture everything. So this, in the sense that it would not just end that day, it can continue, you can watch it again and again and again on television. So what happens to that particular type of experiment? I see it as very, very realistic, very, very, it will bring profit. So why not stick to that method?
Well, that's you're talking about multimedia now. It's good, no doubt about it. But is it, again, it's also synonymous to the film and the television. But we're talking about live theater. It's not the same as live theater. Yes, it's a capture of the action live. But then you are no longer, there's no personal interaction, connection between the player and the audience anymore. The third wall has been broken. So
if I see something like that after, who can tell me that? I mean, you could have gone to post-production.
Now you talked about this situation. Is that not breaking the third wall, watching it from home and having it happen live right here?
Breaking the third wall. You're right. You see, but the impact, even though I agreed with you that I had some impact, I mean, it was very, very impactful on me watching him. But I tell you, if these were a live stage and I was there, the impact that I am going to get is going to be much more stronger,
intense,
you know, more intense than what that, because was, I would know that, except me or him, or probably him that knows the script or the play by Olaru Timi, you will know that okay, Adeoye is exact in what he has presented, but to the general audience, it will look doctored. It could look doctored because you have gone through some other post-production
I think that if theater practitioners should adopt that, then that is actually
for commerce.
You can do that for commerce. You cannot use that to replace live theater performance.
I actually think that I'll be shooting yourself in the foot. For a theater arts practitioner to go up and do something like that and then want to package it and sell it that way. Because, hey, come on, what's the difference between that and what I can
and what I can
and
buy
watch,
on the
and watch? Okay, sir. So now let's see now. What is the part you spoke about government? What can practitioners do? Because you see, while we were talking, I thought about comedy as an industry, how much the industry has grown and all that. We'll round up with this, but then what can, let's see, let's leave the government now. If the government decides to tarry as long as they want to, what can practitioners do of themselves? What can NANTAP do to make itself self-sufficient? What can it do?
Well,
perchance the government, still wait on the government and they can't do anything.
Well, government has a responsibility. Everywhere in the world, government has a responsibility to promote culture.
Exactly.
Everywhere in the world, from America to here.
So I'm saying that if the government doesn't do anything,
if they don't do anything, the best that the practitioners can do is to practice their art as minimal as they can have it.
Mm.
You know, a lot of people are doing it. If you go around, you will see two-handers, you will see solo performances, monologues, and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But yet, the same challenges. They are faced with the same challenges. For instance, if you take a monologue and you say you want to do in a space and you are asked to pay X amount of money and you are not sure you are going to get the monies back, how do you manage? And now, those days, I remember when we used to do little theaters, they would ask us to go back home and get monies from our parents, get from our friends, get costumes and all that. People are tired. People don't want to do that. And so if you find out that if you don't get help from anywhere, you find the theater artist on his own, and you find him trying to look for something else to do so that he can raise money from there to do. And sometimes when they drift like that, they never come back.
Mm.
We have a lot of them. We have a lot of theater practitioners who have gone into other industries with the idea of raising money from there to come back and do theater, and they never come back to do the theater.
The money raises them.
The money raises them. Mm. But we're hoping that, you know, with more advocacy that we do, you know, the private sector, because it's really not about government. You know, government has so much that they are thinking about now, you know, that they will have money for everything. We are hoping that with the advocacy that we do, with the interest that we call to the theater, we will have more people from the private sector, we will have foundations, we will have people with interest, you know, live theater, coming to support the theater. And that is why on Tuesday, that's tomorrow, we are hoping that we will attract non-theater practitioners, people in business, people who have foundations, retired people, people who have retired in business, who have some money somewhere that they can drop for theater performance, to come, you know, and see what we do. And we are going to show them performances to see. They are going to hear from the practitioners on the state of theater practice in the country. They are going to hear from the leaders of NANTAP. We are going to tell them how we can use theater to grow the economy, to diversify the economy. Yeah. We are going to tell them how we can use theater to promote cohesion, to fight against corruption
and terrorism.
I mean,
what is happening on Tuesday? What is it?
Yeah,
is that an event?
That's tomorrow, the event.
The
World Theater Day,
the Lagos chapter.
Okay, so just give us a rundown of what's happening tomorrow.
Quickly, sorry, before we go into that, I wanted to add a little to what you just said. By way of advocacy, what we can do as an association is to engage in advocacy to government, to private sectors, and to our members. And part of what we're trying to do, which I'm sure will probably bring fruition in a short while, is cooperatives. You ask directly, what are we doing ourselves?
Yeah.
Like I said, we're talking about money, we're talking about funding. And if government will not do anything, if private sectors are not doing much, they've done a little bit. I mean, the private sector, for instance, I mean, there used to be a bank who was sponsoring theater every year before. Mm. So we cannot rule out the fact that the private sector has been involved in the theater before. But we're also encouraging ourselves, our members, to go into cooperatives. You and I and I will put together our funds, our little funds, and then we'll put up a production. There, I won't be paid as a director or as an actor or as a costumier or as a set person on the thing, except probably other actors that are brought in from the outside. And whatever proceed is put in is pulled together, you know, is put in a pool and revolved until probably we have. That's like I said, if government would not help us, the private sector are timid in coming to our aid, then of course we can also try and do something for ourselves to promote our profession. like the other question you asked, is the a member of
very quickly tomorrow at the National Theatre, beginning from 3 o'clock. Yeah, we are going to open the curtains for our own celebration, the Lagos State NANTAP celebration of the International World Theatre Day. We are going to have performances, you know, by the Crown Troupe, by some other actors and actresses who are pulling themselves together, who are donating performances on that day. We're going to have an advocacy talk by a former Secretary General of NANTAP, Mr. Israel Lebo. He's a fellow of the profession. We're going to have so many performances just celebrating theater at the National Theater tomorrow.
Tributes to our
and then, of course, we are going to have a special tribute to our fallen heroes, those who have died, you know, over time working in theater, like Tony, like Michael Diachi.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah, the names will go on. If we want to talk, we'll keep on going like this. But then, thank you very much. We're looking forward to it tomorrow.